Once down on some time, in the near dark, and parkathosist, there lived into kinds of kids. The brode was dodgered Hazel. The sister was dodgered Gracie. They lived with dear big daddy was to be bad about cutting sticks. When the kids was small such as no mall, the big daddy had plenty of walk to do, and there was always food in the fridge. Sadly, the moda had got wasted earlier cause being murdered by some black wastia and cage old man, and they also had some new stepmoda Hazel who was being cruel, greedy, and nasty. Slap my fro! What the crap is you hangin', playing all of the silly games again? Yous done didn't know yet plovy stupid games. Right on. Now go and make yourself full. Right on. Go and cut some wood. Right on. And yet kids, go to bed. Right on. You plumbing nonsense. Shouted the A-damn stepmoda Hazel. Hazel and Gracie was glad some supper. Supper? Cheers, no food in the crib. Right on. Do as I say, go to bed. Right on. If I know what's be bad about for ya, and ya got sold any wood for weeks, your horrible kids is eating out crib. But the A-damn big daddy pleaded and pleaded with his Hazel, but she was real puzzled, eh? Her mind was been made out. Man. She ranted so smutch, he gave him agreed to make his wish. Lop some boogie. If they stay with me, we got stop won't starve for us. Then snatch them into the woods tomorrow, and please make sure man you mosey on down back us alone. Replied stepmother Hazel. Hazel and Gracie overheard what was being said. Hazel got a clever plan, and he jimmed his bedroom window and climbed out and spot into the light. Man. He filled his pockets with some small stones and the A-damn crept back to his room. Word. The next morning, stepmother Hazel got a heavy heart. The big daddy took Hazel and Gracie to judge woods. These animals saw two kids walk in the woods. I wonder where those three kids is going off to, said the A-damn rabbit. Man. These gots to be going into the woods for some picnic. Company got the beat, said the A-damn snow kicker hare. I bet there some animals in deer. Didn't they no look like some country code? The country code is, to which SpongeBob plans to hear an earlier fire learned on the gingerbread crib, explained the A-damn mouse. Don't go in with ya. Deeper and deeper in the woods they went. Man. Every often, Hazel dropped one of some stones on the ground to some trail. Eventually, they're sitting via down the forest. Man. Hazel and Gracie is tired and they fallen asleep. Jays hang loose, brud. The big daddy crept silently and creeps away. Slap my fro. As the wood could have planned, Dano'd been cut by some stick with his hand, and he escaped crib safely. Slap my fro. At the A-damn night time, Hazel and Gracie started to wait down, and started to nappy. Slap my fro. We're all alone. Right on. We got Starneva find some way crib. Right on. Cried Gracie. They followed the A-damn trail of stones until at last they reached crib safely. Slap my fro. The big daddy was so happy to see him again. Esku, bro. And the A-damn stepmother Hazel, as which Hazel, was real furious. The hell is you hanging back here? Right on. Ah, we had already sent out all your room. Right on. You single quote s single quote well got sleep in the barn, and in the morning, you gots to go back into the woods seek your fortune. Let's hope if some big bad odd wolf throw some bad odd bear gots meeting you down for dinner time. You wretched kiddies. Right on. Sweared strongly stepmother Hazel, and sent off kids to barn. Esku, bro. Stepmother Hazel locked Hazel and Gracie in the barn. Esku, bro. It was real dark and noisy. Slap my fro. Birds tooted out on some distance. Deer be no lightin'. Insects buzzing in the drafters. Spiders spinning webs in the corners. The whistling trees is sadly. Slap my fro. An owl tooted on his car nearby. Slap my fro. Hazel and Gracie was cold and hungry and they couldn't sleep. Jays hang loose, brud. Suddenly, Hazel and Gracie heard some funky tinkling sound and was saw some tiny light. Man! It was some fairies carrying light lanterns. Oh, what gots we here, to kiddies? What is you hangin' in de barn? Esplain de a damn fairy. Slap ma fro. And after all, it's ma birdie and I decided came here fo ma party. Slap ma fro. And she raps happy birdie. Slap ma fro. And hangin' some boogin' jig. What it is, mama. And after de party, Hazel and Gracie fell asleep earlier. I'll be bad odd. In de mornin', de big daddy and de a damn stepmother Hazel woke them down. Wait down, you lazy lancers. We're all now going woods for some superfine picnic. Company got de beat. Make sure man we'll truly dig lost dee's time. Tell a stepmother Hazel. They went via down woods. So soften, Hazel dropped some piece of bread. They followed the trail back crib. But they done didn't notice that some of those pigeons was following them. Word. To which who got stop jiggered and K which be an evil little kid wants unavailable them. Word. Two hunters came and Gracie dinks be away crib. But how can we can swim across? Said Hazel. Yo. Why don't you plum go swimming across to booze? Said Gracie. It's too deep swim. Word. Said the A-damn hunter. I'll be bad odd. Why don't you plumb wade across? Said Hazel. But how we can wait here? Said Gracie. It can't wait here, they need some boat. Man! De boat needs swim here and but some animals got stop disappear. I'll be bad odd. Replied the A-damn hunter. I'll be bad odd. But he rent Hazel and Gracie his boat, and they some crossed the A-damn river. I'll be bad odd. The two kids was still trying to find the A-damn way crib. They're real hungry and real tired. They was still seriously lost. Man! Whilst Hazel and Gracie went see the A-damn bright sparkly. Slap ma fro! De moods boozed. De walls be made of gingerbread. They're tasted it. Man! De roof was made of chocolate. Even flowers was made of lollipops. Hazel and Gracie had some feast. Man! N.K. which came. But the A-damn N.K. which used some speltic to kids in some Conog right prison. Esku, bro. It was plum deer was being unavailable drajo single quote dan single quote Esku, so cut me some slack, Jack. Hazel and Gracie felt around, but deer be no escape. Every day, N.K. which eats them lots of candies, cream cakes, and cheeseburgers. One day, the rabbit crept out while N.K. which was looking at it. Man, N.K. which been site member, I'll be bad odd. She inspected two kids each day to see if they're to fat cook. You know, crap, dad plum skill skin and bone. Right on. Tonight, it got stop be making boy burger swig toenail sauce for tea. Word, let's dig the oven eyebolly. Slap ma fro. N.K. which is of a newbie being stuck. You know, Gracie would done did she was be told. As soon as N.K. which jimbed the oven to, Gracie gave N.K. which some big push onto the hot eight and shoulders was stuck in fast. Man, in some big rage, she was burning down and ran out the a damn crib with the oven on N.K. which's head. So Hazel and Gracie ran into the garden and bumped into the rabbit's back. You know, but she made an early accident. Man. Time go crib boys and goats, but snatch these. It's made a bag of gold when do which be burning hole in some garden. Esku, bro. But I've dungeon down for ya. Now run crib. Quickly axe the a damn rabbit. Man. Hazel and Gracie pops the hole onto the ground, and ran crib away. Slap ma fro. Mop up the kitties. How I was wish they would mosey on down crib safe and sound. But stepmother Hazel, also known as Jodan, got sagged be wasted by now, so cut me some slack, Jack. Don't even see my two kids again. Esku, bro, said the A-damn big daddy, and fallen with tears of fader's eye and got stop he was crying. Hazel and Gracie back crib. They got stop able loved the A-damn big daddy and his own drug of gold. Big daddy gave them out of a surprise. That's the end of our story. Slap ma fro. The stepmother Hazel had got wasted and now they lived happily ever after. I'll be bad odd. They had N.K. to which is gold and now they was rich. Lop some boogie. They're always still food on the fridge. And da damn Big Daddy Neva Hags cut da damn fire sticks. The creatures and animals scattered around da damn happy fairy tale. The end.